Hello everybody, I'm Stephen Wills of Procurement Central. Thank you to Global Sources for giving me the opportunity to be able to present on secrets of effective supplier relationship management, certainly during these uncertain times. So very happy to be at the live show and really excited. I hope to be hearing some questions from you and certainly to engaging with you on this critical subject. So as mentioned, I'm Steve Wills and I have spent a lifetime in procurement and had an amazing career. And now we have a consultancy training and development company that focuses on making procurement central to the business. And we cover all matters procurement and buying. And what we do is we aim to enable companies to be effective through supply chain excellence. We've got lots of resources on our website. Please come and have a look, www.procurementcentral.co.uk. In addition, we've got books, we've got online videos, we've got some free on-demand resources you can watch, but all centered around how strategic procurement is to a business. We're going to be sharing some time together, about 20, 25 minutes. Feel free to chat and feel free to ask any questions you like. So let's talk a bit about why supplier relationship management protects your business from supply chain disruption. So we know that we're living in very uncertain times. We know that we're forever changing and we have challenges in the environment and with recession and also now pandemics. So lots of opportunities to disrupt a supply chain unless you've made preparation with the suppliers of your choosing to fit the right suppliers into your business, to plug them in and make sure that your business is secure for all its critical goods and services. So what does SRM do, supplier relationship management? What does it do? Well, the first thing is it's a strategic approach. It's looking at whole life costs, the total cost of ownership. It's not just looking at price. We don't just focus on price. We focus on all the associated costs that go with that. We don't focus on a tactical approach short term. This is longer term. And it makes sure that we segment our spend, all of our spend we look at in totality, holistically, and we focus on the top quadrant, which is where the supplier relationship comes in. We source partnerships, we source companies that we can be collaborative with, not just focusing on a quick transaction. We think ahead, we think about some of the consequences. We use tools like PESEL and STEEPL to think about the political, the economical, the social change that's happening in the environment around us. We think about future risks. We think about future proofing our supply chains, making sure that the risks that are out there and the market, ever-changing markets out there are analyzed effectively to make sure that we are taking the right actions at the right time to be able to ride the risks and ride the changes that are happening around us. I'm going to talk to you about a particular case study which illustrates supplier relationship management in action. So we're going to focus on something that I was involved in and really came across the effectiveness of what I was doing really at the start of the process and all the way through the process, and choosing the right suppliers and making sure that the right approach was taken with the suppliers to have effective supplier relationship management that ensured that when difficulty came around, we had the right approach in place. So the Olympic Games is probably the biggest show on earth. It comes around every 4 years. Having said that, obviously with the pandemic, this year will have to be deferred to next year. So that's an unusual event, but typically it comes around every 4 years, and every country is has an opportunity to get involved in that. So what we look for, because we're showcasing our country, we're showcasing our cities, and we're looking for the highest quality, the best suppliers, the best service that we can get. That's the sourcing criteria. We're going out and we're focusing on who it is that can help us to deliver this amazing event. So about 250, what I would describe as SMEs, one business, in addition to that, to make up the 500 suppliers, an exclusive club of suppliers, we also had larger companies as well. About 90% of the suppliers were UK based. That is to say, they supported the UK economy, which is what the Olympic Games, when it was won, was set out to do when it was brought to the UK. And about 66% of suppliers were not from London. They were throughout the UK. So business won all across the UK. Critical to the British athletics team and to UK in general, and this whole supply chain that was put together was critical for the organizing committee. So it was a magnificent showcase, not just for the UK, not just for athletics, but also for supply chain management. Underpinning all of this were the values of inclusivity, sustainability, that there was a lot of talk about creating a legacy of the work that we were doing in deprived areas, as well as diversity. We needed a governance, we needed structure. All selection of suppliers within a business needs to have order, to have forethought, to be considered what it is we're trying to do. We need to know what our strategy is, what our approach is, what are the specifications, what are the requirements for the goods, services, and materials that we aim to need in the case of the Olympic Games. Security, logistics, catering, soft facilities, hard facilities, all things associated with putting on an event. So with the different categories, of those of you that have come across category management, we would apply category management in the thinking process about who it was that we wanted to select. We would think about segmenting our spend. We would have a kickoff project to define our requirements, to think about our approach, to gather the data, to look at the budgets that we had available to spend from Treasury, to think about developing the strategy even before we started to go looking for suppliers. We don't jump straight into that. We need a lot of preparation, a lot of planning. And of course, once we've gone through the sourcing process, we've analyzed the market, and we've come across perhaps some companies that we believe we could possibly work with, there's still a lot of work to do before we mobilize and put in place a fit for purpose contract, a legal agreement with a service level agreement with key performance indicators that we can measure, and of course that we can use to work the relationship with the supplier. Across all of this were things like having a commercial panel that met to decide, not just by procurement, but by the business, by the legal team, by the finance team, about the agreement. Everybody needed to be on board. This isn't just one person's view. Not one person can go and select goods and services. Everybody needs to be on board with supplier relationship management to make it effective and work. They all need to get the message. They all need to understand why this is important to the business. So looking at the quality, the delivery, and the legacy that we were going to leave in place, understanding all of the reasons why we went out to select a supplier. What we don't want is misunderstanding with the business and, of course, filtering through to the supplier. So this was our governance. This is a governance you can use to think about how you can select suppliers, how you can find suppliers that are going to be right for your business to have a relationship with, that really protects you in normal times, but also in these uncertain times as well. So one way you can do this is with the CrowdCheck matrix, and think about how CrowdCheck would identify that not everything is the same. We don't use a one-size approach for everything. Think about that there are other things that require, let's call it, a different relationship, that there are non-critical items. There are categories that we can think of, spend categories, that do not require the full partnership relationship, the full collaboration relationship that seeks continuous improvement. That is what we put in the top right-hand corner of our CrowdCheck matrix. Big, complex, high-risk pieces of spend, and also things that can impact the bottom line, that can impact on our spend and our profitability and our performance of our organization and business. These are the companies that will probably carry 80% of the spend with 20% of the suppliers. Yes, there will be other things. There will be areas that are less complex, less risky, but have a big impact on the company's performance, the leveraged items. There will be items that are also considered to be challenges in the bottleneck space as well. These are very complex, but probably don't impact so high on the profit and the performance of the business. So let's talk a little bit about the Olympic Games. Let's talk a little bit about the background that we face. This is just highlighting that after some attacks that were held in London, we had a revision of our needs to consider new security risks. And that meant that the potential spend of security rose to about £350 million. We had an existing supplier that had been found when we had the previous requirements, but because of the recent events, the recent attacks in the capital, this meant that the new supplier would have to do things differently, would have more responsibility, and would have more spend with them. And so we had to find some more government money. As I've said, it was looking at a budget of an estimate of 350 million, and the existing embedded supplier was asking us to give them the go-ahead to start spending that money so that they could meet the embedded timeline, which was immovable. The opening ceremony was immovable, and consequently, the clock was ticking away. The pressure was therefore on to agree a go-ahead, and a very complex set of requirements were being asked now from the embedded supplier, meaning a small army of people, about 23,000 people, accommodation for them, food for them, catering, training for them, uniforms, as well as scanning equipment and CCTV. So there was a lot at stake, there was a lot happening in a very short period of time. So the way that I dealt with that, the way that the team dealt with that, the way that we looked at it was to make sure that we could probably take some, coming back to crowd check, to take some of the less important, the less critical items and start work on them, and to start to deep dive into areas of spend that were highly complex, highly risky, and were probably the most expensive. So going back to crowd check, spend analysis across the list of requirements, looking at the accommodation, the training, the scanning equipment, and so on. Segmenting that and analyzing it, but there were some non-critical items we could get on and start ordering those. Looking at making sure we had controls in place as the orders went out, that we made sure that they were clear and that they were raised with a purchase order so that we controlled the spend. We made sure that we worked with people in government who also bought security services and spent a lot of money. And we managed to create a combination of about 700 million of spend that we were able to get some leverage, as well as looking at the future for this company and making sure that new opportunities in the future could be considered by government and by the Olympics as well, if the job was done well. So workshops were held to get the message, to be on message, and to get everybody in the same place, particularly the stakeholders and the sponsors. And we started to talk to the supplier about a new contract, a new type of contract that had some gain share with them and consequences if they were not able to deliver. We looked at extensive key performance indicators with some penalties around them for non-performers. This was going to be a lot more tensioned than the previous contract now, because it was much bigger, more complex. We were talking about the top right-hand box now. We were in the high end of supplier relationship management. So things needed to be changed with the relationship itself. The consequence of all this is that the budget was reduced. We didn't end up paying as much as we first considered we would. So about £100 million were saved. And also, it was a safe outcome for the Olympics. The event passed by without incident. And so the needs were met. The outcomes were met as well. So my message to you in a six-point summary is, when you're considering the possibility that you will have disruption, that you could have failure, that you could have stockouts, and you can miss key deadlines in your business, your supply chain is vital to avoid all of that. So you need a strong governance to help the decision making. You have to put the work in place ahead of finding suppliers and putting a contract in. You cannot just go straight to finding suppliers and contracting with them. You need to do a lot of work in-house. Specify what you need, not what you want. We all want the high end, but we need to have the essentials. So think about that. That's how we saved 100 million out of that budget, by considering what we need rather than what we want. Source and select partners that you can collaborate with, that understand your culture, that understand your business. Think about CrowdCheck. He says, not one size fits everything. And adopt your relationships, your collaborative relationships, your partnership relationships. Adopt them and look at continuous improvement and continuous quality in the top right-hand box. Not every supplier fits that. Not every supplier is worthy of your time to do that. And your mission is to use SRM for added value. So just a quick summary, we are available to any company or any individual who wants to develop themselves and to think about the procurement function. So keeping momentum to assure supply chains deliver goods and services. We are Procurement Central. I very much enjoyed talking to you, and I look forward to hearing some questions, any questions you like, and to hearing your feedback. Thank you very much.